Hello Warriors, thanks for joining me for this week's edition of Science for A's videos. Last week we had a look at the role of anti-inflammatories or NSAIDs in ankylosing spondylitis. This week let us have a look at what are traditional NSAIDs, what are COX-2 selective NSAIDs and the difference between the two when it comes to ankylosing spondylitis. NSAIDs as a group are known to cause gastritis or acid related issues. And at times when severe, they can even cause stomach ulcers. The scientific community is always focused on ways and means to reduce the side effects of medicines. In the case of NSAIDs, it meant ways and means to reduce the gastritis or acidity related side effects. NSAIDs block inflammation by blocking an enzyme called cyclooxygenase or COX. There are two types of COX enzymes in the body. COX-1 and COX-2. COX-1 is present in the stomach lining and blocking it leads to acidity related issues, while COX-2 is present at the sites of inflammation, something that is relevant for ankylosing spondylitis. So scientists were looking for molecules that would block COX-2, that is inflammation, and not block COX-1 so as to reduce the side effect of acidity. This is how COX-2 selective anti-inflammatories or NSAIDs were born. Celecoxib by the brand name Celebrex, Rofecoxib by the brand name Vioxx, Valdecoxib by the brand name Bextra, and Etoricoxib by the brand name Arcoxia, Retos, Nucoxia, Etoshina are all examples of selective COX-2 blockers. Naproxen, Diclofenac, Indomethacin, Pyroxicam are examples of traditional NSAIDs. When the COX-2 selective blockers were launched, they were used in a big way in big numbers, thinking that the side effect related to acidity, gastritis would be reduced. And they did so when used in patients. Most of the studies have shown that in ankylosing spondylitis, there is no major difference in the efficacy, in the effectiveness of anti-inflammatory or pain relieving action between the two types of NSAIDs, whether it is COX-2 selective or traditional. Both of them are equally effective. After their launch, further studies and post-marketing surveillance started showing that celecoxib, rofecoxib and valdecoxib significantly increase the risk of heart attack and stroke. This is so because the COX enzymes are also present in the blood vessels and the platelets, and blocking them increase the risk of heart attack and stroke. Bextra and Vioxx were withdrawn from the market. Celecoxib is still available in the US market, while Etoricoxib is not approved in the US but is available and approved in almost 80 countries across the globe. When it comes to us rheumatologists, we take into consideration the risk factor the patient has when it comes to choice of the NSAIDs, whether traditional NSAIDs or the COX-2 selective NSAIDs. If a person has gastritis or acidity issues, then COX-2 selective NSAIDs are preferred. Whereas if the person has cardiac risk factors like high blood pressure, high cholesterol, diabetes, obesity, smoking, then COX-2 selective NSAIDs are not chosen. So all in all, NSAIDs have an important role to play in ankylosing spondylitis. The choice between traditional NSAIDs or COX-2 selective NSAIDs is not because of the difference in efficacy in ankylosing spondylitis, but it is more related to the side effect profile, the risk factor profile a person would have. Thank you for watching this episode. Next week, we would be looking into details of the side effect profile, the renal, gastric and the heart related issues these NSAIDs possess. See you next week. Thanks again.